Hey everyone, hope you guys are doing well. Welcome back to another video. So today, as usual, again my hair is a bit messy and I'm sort of liking it because I used to like straighten my hair, you know, for shooting, and now I just want to keep them like open and, you know, just keep them a bit wavy. So as you know, the title says today it's gonna be the review and swatches of Huda's two new launches. So apparently these like launched abroad I think a month back, and finally I got my hands on them. Actually the Naughty palette by Huda was out of stock on Selfridges, and around like December end or Jan, I guess, yeah, around Jan it came back in stock and I could just buy it and get it and do a swatch video for you guys. So I was also eyeing their Huda stick foundation as well. So apparently every brand has just come out with a lot of new foundations, and I think you guys are gonna see like a lot of foundation reviews and swatches, you know, in the coming weeks. So moving on directly to what exactly we're going to be doing today. So today is going to be the swatches of the Naughty palette, and this is so gorgeous, I must say. The shades are so pretty, and the swatches of the Huda's stick foundation, which is Fox Filter Skin Finish. So this is the way the stick foundation looks. This is so sleek and it is actually very easy to hold. Like, I personally like, you know, stick foundations when they have like, you know, a good grip. So I'm actually new to trying stick foundations, and let's see how this goes. Like I said, I have also tried one from MAC, and I never bought it because I found it a bit too thick and you know, very not so easy to just glide on your face. So since it was a matte finish foundation, maybe it was a bit rough, but let's see how this one goes. And so this is the way it is, guys, and I'm in the shade Tres Leches. So all these like foundation sticks have like, you know, names based on sweet, and this is like Tres Leches is like a type of cake, and it is in the number 320 gold. So I really hope you guys can see. I'm just gonna like get it a bit closer so you guys can see the name. So there it is, it's Tres Leches, and it's in the shade 320 gold. So I am like a very warm undertoned person, so even if like I change a foundation, like for example if a foundation is very warm undertoned or not golden, there's a difference between being warm and golden, they're two different things. And even when you say a foundation is peach but it's warm, it's a completely different undertone. So mostly I'm golden, and whenever I buy, you know, foundations which are supposed to go with golden undertone, whenever I buy a foundation which is supposed to go with golden undertone, it basically flatters my skin a lot. And this is 320g again, guys, for you, and it is Tres Leches. So I'm gonna like swatch it on my face directly for you guys, and then we're going to blend it, and then we will move on to the Huda Beauty's eyeshadow palette, the Naughty eyeshadow palette. I've just sort of color coordinated my top, you know, for the palette. So I'm going to directly swatch this on my face, and I'm just going to take my mirror and get it. So I think this is going to be like, so it's written buildable coverage foundation stick. So this foundation is a creamy stick formula foundation which melts into your skin. This is what's mentioned on the Huda's website, and this is like a very buildable coverage foundation. So if you want a full coverage foundation, you can apply more, and it is also a very customizable foundation, like I said, and it's a natural finish foundation. This is vegan, which is very good, and it is waterproof, and it's 10 hour wear foundation. So I really like the fact that this foundation has such a great packaging, and it is so, I think, space compliant as well. I don't think this will take a lot of space, you know, in anybody's bag, or for example my vanity bag or my vanity pouch as well. So for the directions, it is said that for light to medium coverage, directly use onto your face and buff out with your favorite sponge or brush, and you can repeat it to build the coverage. But for full coverage, it says that swipe foundation directly on a dense flat brush and apply to your face. So I'm going to try to do both the things here, and I'm going to apply the foundation stick directly onto my face on this side and build the coverage, and then go ahead with putting it on the brush and putting it onto my face. So we will see whether the thing works or not. So obviously it's gonna work, but let's just do it for this review video. And I'm just going to take the foundation onto my face first. Oh, it's my perfect shade. This is like actually my skin color. Wow, this is literally my skin color, and this is so creamy. So it's not matte finish, but it has a very nice natural finish. I'm just gonna like dot a bit. Wow, this is so cute. So I'm gonna take this brush from pack and just blend it. So you guys can see how the foundation has worked onto my skin. This is very pretty, I must say, and this is a very lovely creme finish foundation. You obviously feel the foundation touch whenever whenever I'm touching it. I feel like this foundation, which obviously happens when you're using a matte foundation and obviously a stick foundation as well. But I really like the coverage of this foundation, that even with medium coverage is given pretty good coverage. As usual, I don't have a lot of dark circle problems, so you guys can see my dark circles are not visible. So next I'm gonna go ahead and take this flat brush from pack and take the foundation and then apply it onto my skin. So let's see how this goes. This is the way they've directed it, so I'm just going to take it like this. And it actually picks up like a lot of foundation, you guys can see. So this is gonna be like a very good coverage sort of trick. So thank you for Huda for sharing this, because I mean seriously, if I wouldn't have read that, I myself wouldn't have known how to like directly get full coverage from a stick foundation. But I really had like I really liked stick foundations because they're so, I mean, they look so easy to use. But wow, I think I've just finished half of my face, and you guys can see that it's just covered up almost everything. And there's a difference, right? You guys can see there's more foundation on this side, and this side is pretty medium coverage, which is good. So this trick works. Thanks, Huda. And I'm just gonna move up onto my forehead and take a bit more and move it up onto my forehead. So, okay, this works. So you guys can see that there's an actual difference, and this side is like more coverage and this side is like medium coverage. So pretty much I really like the coverage of the foundation. I'm just gonna zoom in a bit so you guys can see how this works. So you guys can see it's pretty much covered up everything from my face, and even on this side, like the blemishes and everything are just gone. So which is something very, very nice. So I basically just like the versatility of this foundation, and mostly I think all stick foundations are very customizable, and even this one here is very, very customizable. You guys can use it the way you want. So being a cream foundation, it also gives you a very nice glow on your face. It makes your skin look very natural and healthy. This is what I can say, because it's also mentioned that it's gonna give you a natural finish. But even giving you a natural finish, like you guys can see, it's giving me a very nice glow as well, which is something good. So if you guys have been eyeing for a stick foundation and you guys are confused which one to buy, I think you guys can go ahead with this one, because this is pretty, pretty good. So what we're gonna do is, now we're gonna quickly move on to the eyeshadow palette, and I'm gonna open it in front of you guys and show you how it looks. So it comes in this packaging like this, and this is the way it is. Like, it comes in a very nice, lovely burgundy packaging. This is so gorgeous to look at, and it's so sexy. So this is the way the shades look on the inside. You guys can see that they have come up with something new as well, especially this one here. Like this one in particular, they have come out with a new finish, and basically they have like these you know, pigment bubbles inside, and it's dispersed in like a very thick jelly like texture. And apart from that as well, you guys can see that these shades here as well, like they have the matte shade and they have like, you know, the shimmer along with it, so it looks very aesthetically pleasing and it's very, very pretty. And you guys can see that I used this shade a bit because I was very curious to see how it is. But when you're like rubbing it in, you know, so when you're like rubbing your fingers in, the pigment sort of comes out from the bubbles and it comes onto your finger, so you guys can see how the shade is. And this is the way it is. So it's very light pigmented shade. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna do a very quick makeup look, and I'll try to use this. Let's see how this goes. Apart from that, I'm very excited to try, you know, the shimmer shades more because they're so pretty. Like, I'm just gonna swatch this one here. You guys can see this one in particular, like it has the matte shade here and it has a shimmer as well. So let's see how this is so smooth to touch. Wow. So you guys can see when I like, you guys can see the swatch that the two shades just mix together. And they just like came out in a color like this, which is so pretty. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do a very quick makeup look, and I really wanna use like all of the shades from this palette, but you know that I can't do it. So I'm just gonna create a very quick look, and I'm going to try to use the shade Slippery. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do the eyeshadow look first, and then I'm gonna swatch the shades on my hand all together so you guys can see the swatches of the shades as well. First, I'm gonna go ahead with the shade Rough and just take it all around my eyes. So I really like this color. It's not even like that dark, but I really think that it's served the purpose. So next I'm going to go ahead with the shade Naughty, and this is like a very lovely mid-tone brown color. Next I'm going to go ahead with the shade Untamed, and I'm taking a smaller brush from Pack because I really want the pigment to be a bit dense, and let's see how this goes. So at this point I'm very confused, you know, whether I should go ahead with a gold shade or go ahead with Slippery. But since Slippery is the most anticipated shade and everybody's curious, I'm gonna go ahead with Slippery and let's see how this swatches. So I'm gonna go ahead with my fingers and just put it. So this is like a very glossy shade. Like it's almost like a very liquid eyeshadow like texture. It obviously looks like that, but I'm really, really happy with the shade. Even though I could have like done, you know, a glitter in between just to, you know, like see how this goes, but I really liked the look that has come out. It is so sexy. It's not even too gaudy. I really don't think that it's that gaudy, and I think I can just put like an eyeliner and fix this look, or I really even think that a mascara will just finish off the look. So I'm gonna finish the look with the Huda's Legit Lashes mascara, and I'm gonna use the side of Volume. So I finished off the look basically with the mascara, and I'm using the shade from MAC, which is Sin. I know it's looking a bit dramatic, but I really feel that, you know, I could just do it for now. So moving on to the final part of the video, I'm going to be swatching these on my hand, and so you guys get a better clarity of the shade. So the first shade is called Filthy, and this is like a very light lilac pink shade. The next shade is Passion, and this is like a mix of a very lovely deep burgundy with blue metallic color. The next shade is called Shameless, and this is a very lovely true metallic pink color. The next shade is Please Me, and this is a very lovely mid-tone brown metallic shade. The next shade is Hypnotic, and this is a very lovely light brown shade. This shade is really perfect to create like a very lovely even base if you want, and blend the colors on top of this. The next shade is Hard, and this is a very lovely brownish ochre color. So it has a mix of brown and ochre, so that's the reason it looks like this. The next shade is Untamed, and this is a very lovely deep burgundy shade. This is a very 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 sexy color. The next shade is called Irresistible, and this is a very lovely metallic rose gold shade. It's a very 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 pretty color. The next shade is called Flower Power, and this is also a very lovely gold metallic shade. The next shade is Rough, and this is a very lovely mid-tone brown color. The next shade is called Spicy, and this is a very lovely deep burgundy shade. This is so gorgeous, you guys can see how pretty it is. The next shade is Arouse, and this is again a very lovely neutral orangey brown shade. The next shade is Slippery, and you guys already saw the swatches first. This is a very light burgundy shade, but it's like in a very jelly like texture. The next shade is Tantric, and this is a very lovely gold shade. This is very different from Flower Power. Flower Power is a very light gold shade, but this is a true gold metallic color. The next shade is Naughty, and this is a very lovely deep brown shade. The next shade is Provocative, and this is a very lovely purple plum shimmer shade. The next shade is called Desire, and this is a very lovely deep rose pink metallic shade. And the last and the final shade is called Juicy, and this is again a very lovely brown matte shade. So coming down to the final reviews, like I really like the foundation, and when it comes to the Naughty palette as well, they have like variety of browns and especially variety of, you know, deep shades, which is something very nice. Like there was like different types of browns, because sometimes what happens is when you want to create like intense looks like this, you sometimes make a mistake and use a very basic brown color and the look just goes off. And you guys can see that the shades that I've used are so pretty that even though I've put a very dramatic lipstick with it, it's just going well with it. And I really like the versatility of this palette, and you know, especially with, you know, having different brown shades. So this palette and the foundation stick is a go from my side. I really really liked both of them. So these are available on Selfridges, and I'm going to attach the link in the description where you guys can buy this. But if you want to wait for it, I think these will come in India very soon. So if you want to wait for that, and when they launch on India, I will attach the link in the description as well once they launch on Nykaa or on Sephora. So if you guys have come up till here, you guys know that I'm going to be giving away free makeup, and I've been collecting these pieces like for quite a time, and finally I thought that I'll give away a few makeup for you 10 lucky girls out there. Since I have 10k followers on Instagram, I really thought that I should give away 10 of you. So I picked up like a lot of products, and each of you are gonna get the best. So if you guys have come up till here, then all you have to do is just subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram and tag 3 of your friends on your Instagram post, and you also have to tell them to subscribe to my channel as well. So if you guys have done that, then you are gonna be selected for this giveaway, and you guys have seen that what I'm gonna be giving away as well. So 10 of you are gonna get these goodies. If you guys obviously like my content and you guys like my videos and my makeup, then also subscribe to my channel and recommend your friends as well. But in the giveaway, you also have to tag 3 of your friends and make them follow me on Instagram and also subscribe to my channel. So that are the rules, guys. So keep going, and I will announce the winner in a week's time. So stay tuned on my channel and stay tuned on my Instagram as well. So hope you guys like the video and hope you guys like the swatches. Do subscribe to my channel and follow me on Instagram as well. So hope you guys like the video again, and see you guys soon.